All right, these so-called zombie deer have now been spotted in 13 Ohio counties. Now, the animals are infected with epizootic hemorrhagic disease, or EHD.
The deer were found in at least four tri-state counties in Ohio for the second time in a little over a week. Local 12's Genesis Narrow shows us some police body camera footage of these zombie deer and explains what to do if you spot one.
Yeah, the zombie deer there.
That's what he was.
Yeah, you probably didn't believe me.
Well, you said zombie deer. I was like,
yep, it's true. Spottings of zombie deer are becoming more and more common in the greater Cincinnati area. Body cam video from Coleraine Police show the moments this deer was found on the side of Blue Rock Road early last week. Police say the deer was found standing and staring off into the distance, never fazed by sirens or officers shouting. And turns out, this behavior is not uncommon. On Sunday, over in the city of Oxford, police found this deer on the south side of town.
The deer was panting. There was blood coming from the eyes, or at least one eye, and it had swelling in its face, which, putting all those together, it was indicative of this EHD.
EHD is transmitted by biting midges, known as noceums, or gnats that breed and live in small pools of standing water. According to the Ohio Department of Natural Resources, some symptoms include disorientation and show little to no fear of humans, pronounced swelling of head, neck, tongue, and eyelids, weakness, circling, and other odd neurological signs.
We have learned that EHD is common in the late summer, early fall season, although this is particularly a bad year for it. We were told that the Oxford area and Houston Woods area has been particularly bad, according to their statistics.
The EHD virus is not infectious to people or pets, but sightings of a sick or dead deer should be reported. You can find all that information posted inside my story over on local12.com. Reporting in Cincinnati, Genesis Narrows, Local 12 News.
Midwestern deer populations have developed little resistance to EHD and are likely to die within 3 days following the onset of symptoms. There is currently no treatment for the disease in wild populations.